we're a small country. It's what I love about New Zealand. We're playing against the odds. We don't have the scale. We're remote from our markets. So my talk was really about how do you turn that to your advantage? How do you use your size, your lack of scale, to be more agile, to be more innovative, to be more entrepreneurial, and to take risk? And really what I challenged people with and confronted people with was, if you're prepared to do that, and really prepared to do that, you've got to be prepared that failure also comes with that, and how you learn and adapt and benefit from failure. Key leadership lessons for me over the last three decades: speed is everything, agility. If you can create a new product, a new service, if you can get to market before someone else, that's where you can create real value and get advantage over your competitors. And I think New Zealand companies are ideally placed to be able to move with speed and agility. Innovation, don't be afraid to use trial and error. You can spend ages researching, agonising, analysing, should I, shouldn't I, give it a go. Find a way to try small, be prepared to make mistakes, adapt, learn, and once you've figured out and refined, then roll out to the scale of the organisation or the scale of the market opportunity. Really, really important. Never compromise the time to communicate with people. Communication is everything, and I probably would spend 70% of my time is communicating with employees, with customers, with communities, with stakeholders, with other organisations, learning and trying to evolve my thinking. So communication, and always be honest and always be authentic. That for me is I guess the essence of what I'm about. So engaging and allowing people to participate in shaping the personality of the organisation is really key, and that needs to be a collaboration, not just between the CEO and the employees, but also the customers, because Air New Zealand's a classic. You know, everyone feels like they own Air New Zealand. It's a part of them. New Zealanders feel that. Our employees feel that. Even our passengers from offshore, I get many emails saying, I love my experience on Air New Zealand. Have you thought about trying this or trying that? They actually want to contribute to our success and who we are. So you have to allow the DNA and the personality to evolve. So you need some pillars to attach it to, but you don't want to become too prescriptive. It has to be organic. My belief is that it's critical that every single employee in the organisation is a leader and sees themselves as a leader in the context of the role that they play in the organisation. So a check-in agent, for example, confronted with a passenger that has a problem or doesn't want to pay an excess baggage fee or whatever, they have to assume a leadership role to resolve that issue. So that's their leadership context. There's always a risk when you empower people to take leadership accountability that they'll make decisions that you wouldn't make. That's the price of empowerment, that's the price of leadership. But ultimately, we found, and this is where it takes trust, we found that that was a very, very small price to pay to enable people to achieve amazing outcomes that I could have never scripted for those people. Self-belief and self-confidence is at the heart of successful leadership. And you know, I've always thought with my kids, actually instilling self-confidence is probably the greatest gift that you can give a child. Because it's through self-confidence that you learn and you're prepared to push the boundaries and put yourself out there. You have to be very resilient, and it does take courage. It does take courage. I can think many a time where I've been in business situations and thought, I really am putting my bum on the line here, and the consequence could be that someone comes to me and says, we don't want you to do this job anymore. You've got to be prepared for that consequence.